Welcome back to Blue Planet War in Heaven for Freespace 2 here on Paladin Gaming. We are going into the 16th mission of the campaign, and this will be a database reading. So let's get to our mission briefing. Masyaf priority communique. Personal distribution eyes only from Thorn. Timestamp discrepancy. Cassandra has identified the mole who sold Taudigani and your Wargods to Steele. Previous simulations never produced the name because it was on an exclusion list. People who were implicitly trusted. Looking back, it's obvious. Who was supposed to go on the Shepsiskov mission but bowed out? Who was close to Admiral Natreba and thus the two fleet planning data? The traitor is an elder, Svetlana Henriksson. Yeah, I don't say. Masyaf secure net. Message received. Sender Aldawa authenticated. Thorne's message went out to you 2 hours ago. I apologize for delaying it, but the information had to remain compartmentalized until we could capture Henriksson. She was on Luna as of 1 hour ago. Unfortunately, our attempt to secure her failed. An SOC unit captured local transit and extracted her. Our tales report that she was moved to the corvette Fortitude for medical treatment, but the Diomedes-class corvette evades them with a series of jumps. Henriksson possesses secrets even I do not, including the details of the Elder's in-state contingency for this war. I have unilaterally authorized her termination. How did they transfer her to a corvette in Luna orbit? What was First Fleet doing? Henriksson is a physicist and statesman of considerable repute. Her personal records indicate that she was motivated by a desire to end this war rapidly and decisively. She saw the Alliance as the inevitable victors. She expresses regret for the loss of Elder Taudigani, but contends that something termed Shambhala is a reprehensible gamble with the lives of billions and possible extinction. If she reaches Artemis Station, the sacrifices we have made to enact the Elder's plan will be rendered meaningless. Thorne will brief you on the intercept. Masyaf priority communique. Distribution Holmes, keywords Shadowfax, source Cassandra. From Cassandra analyst to all operators. Current estimate 18 days plus or minus 3 days until Steele attacks Earth. I think that's going to be a recurring frame. So let's get to our mission briefing. We're going to assassinate ourselves an elder. Everything is permitted. I am online with Cassandra. Prepare for briefing. The GTCV Fortitude extracts Svetlana Henderson and jumps away to elude pursuit. The ship is now recharging its drive. Soon it makes rendezvous with GTVA forces. Henriksson is badly injured. She goes directly to GTD Atreus for debriefing. Fortitude jumps in at a safe range since Artemis is a high traffic area and deploys transports under heavy guard. Transports move faster than the corvette. You take a single Ainsarii, identify the transport carrying Henriksson, and kill her. I don't know why they always do this. Yeah, the transport might be faster, but we can't stop the corvette. Plan of infiltration. Agents left backdoors in Artemis Station comm subsystem. Scan comm subsystem to secure keys for local net. You must identify Henriksson's transport. It may launch from Fortitude, or the transport may have infiltrated another convoy group arriving soon. Both convoy groups make a run for Artemis. You use onboard ESM equipment and comm keys to locate Henriksson. Eavesdrop on the chatter between Artemis, Atreus, and convoy elements. Signal detection meter spikes when you look at a ship sending a message. Listen for spikes that are either from or regarding Henriksson. Use these spikes to identify which ship carries the target. Disregard simple traffic messages. Close in on transport groups to determine which one is transmitting. Evade escort fighters. Visual ID is a risk. Still using Elysiums. Artemis Station contains other backdoors. When hostilities begin, we install backdoors in all assets that might be captured. Scan other subsystems for valuable data or access to networked weapons. When you reveal yourself, the transports will jump away. Bring anti-subsystem missiles such as the Shrike to disable the transport. We arm your fighter with a nav buoy. Deploy it near the convoy group containing the target and activate at your discretion. It summons a suicide transport that will draw the nearest fighter wing to intercept. You can use this decoy to draw the Elder's escorts away. Once you are detected, any AWACS in the area will lock onto you and relay your position. Do not fire until absolutely certain you can kill a target and escape. You have no friendly assets to provide ECM support. Your stealth will be fragile. Exfiltration options. First, you may outrun hostile forces and jump clear. You must not jump until you have several kilometers of safe distance from any hostile. Destroying AWACS radars may help eliminate locks on you. Your best option may be a total system shutdown, disabling all onboard power and gliding clear in a ballistic trajectory. If you take this option, be sure you are moving away from Artemis before you shut down. A shutdown will not save you from visual attack. Get distance from hostile fighters before you attempt it. You may discover other methods of engaging the target on site. If you access networked weapons, you may be able to subvert them and use them on the target. Infiltrate Artemis. Secure keys from its comms subsystem. Identify the Elder's transport via ESM. Draw the escorts off with the decoy transport. Disable the transport's engines. Kill her. Evade and escape. Primary objectives. Define Defector's transport and destroy Defector's transport. Secondary objectives. Hack Artemis subsystems. We have one Ainsarii. We have Shrike EMP missiles and double Gatlers. Alright. Okay, jump successful. Stealth attack, voice recorder live. I'm moving in to scan Artemis comms and get those keys. There's the comms. Atreus is on station along with a logistics ship, three warships, and a number of auxiliaries. I see a Mjolnir net and a small cargo dump. Marcus Glaive is out there. Fixing no keys. Okay, so the Marcus Glaive has jumped out. Where's the hood? Where are the rest of the supply stockpiles? Why is there only one squadron on patrols? Like Steele's most moved most of his forces. The Atreus. She's flanked by an AWACS cruiser. Best not get too close. Huh. So we went in a locket over 6 kilometers from long-range missile. Corvette Fortitude has entered the area. Thorn, you were off by 3 seconds. I hope the rest of your mistakes are that small. Who are you? The Legionary. I remember you. Transports are inbound. Two groups, Omega and Lambda. Henriksson's on one. Need to listen to the chatter, figure out which one. The Legionary. I know that ship. She was at Saturn. Yes, she was. It's a big old turret. Hello, lovely. Give me a whisper. Give me something. I got unfinished business with you, and I'm not a patient woman. Acting the sensor system. If I decouple a static discharge system, I could blind everyone's sensors, including mine. Better watch out and sever my own connection. And there's the other group. Now which one has our dear friend? I don't care what protocols you have in place. Get me your admiral. Get him now. Gunnery net codes, huh? I can hear you, darling. Which one is your ride? Be advised, inbound transports, you're on our traffic pattern. It's Humpback 3-1 Heavy. Please squawk 5,000. Visual. I hear you, Elder Henriksson. The problem is that many others might hear you as well. So we'll have to wait until you're safely aboard the Atreus. Thornet keys, away into the network. Get those guns. My personal safety is irrelevant. I made my choice. That group. Because I believed I could save billions of lives. I need to tell you as much as I can as quickly as possible. Copy, Artemis. We have your beacon. Traffic data and net handshake complete. Standard comms traffic. That won't do me any good. Yeah, well. I appreciate your stand, Elder Henriksson, but given recent events, I do not trust even the most secure channels. I'd rather they not learn exactly how much you know. Humpback, we have two discrete flight plans registered under your name, but no information on which transport is following which. I have a date with one of those transports, but which one? I need to get close and confirm just where some of these transports are. Steele, there are things you do not understand about my Federation. secrets to keep even from themselves. They are dangerous. I could be killed at any moment, and I would rather not die in vain. Sorry, Elemis, Artemis, the element of the flight plan is classified. Admiral Steele's orders. Acknowledge, humpback, proceed to split. Be advised your escort wings have not logged onto our net. I've always suspected as much. You may proceed, Elder Henriksson. Tell me all you can. I see fighters. Same story, right? I must not permit to discuss our escorts at this time. Wait, any guarantees before we proceed? My safety is immaterial, but I expect concessions in exchange for this information. I am a civil servant, Elder Henriksson. I cannot broker a truce. The only way I can end this war is by winning it. Twelve life signs. Come on, Henriksson, say something. Moment, you're the most powerful man in the Alliance. You could dictate terms to Tocqueville. Wait a minute. Did I get mixed up? Steel. You flatter me. Present your demands and I will pass them to appropriate channels. Come on, Henriksson. I will give you Shambhala, and you will use that knowledge to guarantee your victory. In exchange, you will accept the Federation's negotiated surrender. It's that one. Some kind of Black Ops unit called the Fedayeen. We don't know much else. It's Lambda 3. No, it's Omega 3. It's gotta be. Dismantling the Federation's apparatus of control is high on our list of priorities, Elder. Conditional surrender may not be an option. Propaganda. We both know that the Alliance needs to secure Earth in order to solidify its loyalty to its own populace. Strikes to the... And unite against the Shivans. Terra is what matters. Your council is clear sighted, Elder Henriksson. If only they'd all made your choice. We'll see about using this here Mjolnir. Artemis, this is Argus. We're detecting some strange activity on one of our Mjolnir sentries. Can you have one of your wings check it out? Oh boy. Read Argus Epsilon Wing. I hear that humpback. Probably another glitch, but do a quick sweep. Oh shit, I don't have a lot of time. The project is called Shambhala. It began 20 years ago, but the final breakthroughs were not made until the 14th Battle Group defectors brought their expertise to bear. Is it a weapon, a warship, a beam-armed battle group? I need specifics. How typical, Admiral. What would a weapon have done us? You must understand that Shambhala is an answer to a problem that predates this war by decades. It's charging the fire. Shut it down. What's that light? expecting to see more of the fleet at the station, Artemis. Artemis is our issue street activity. There's fighters buzzing around back there. Evade and return to base. Closest target is 6 kilometers away. I'm out. A message there. Whatever secrets Elder Henriksson intended to deliver to Steele, they died with her. The security of the Federation's in-state contingency remains intact, and while it is possible that additional moles exist, the Council itself is secure. We can now operate with enhanced freedom. You performed well in a hazardous environment under tremendous pressure, and in doing so, lived up to the expectations placed on the most reliable of operators. I am pleased. Your creativity in the execution of your mission is to be commended. Subverting the local Mjolnir network to accomplish your task was inspired, and has forced a complete review of software security across the Alliance. Admiral Steele's reaction to the loss of such a critical asset has been outwardly restrained, but make no mistake, there is a shadow war underway in the halls of power on both sides of this war. Our agents and their agents, our stealth ships and theirs, are hunting each other in offices and dark places at this very moment. He sees us as a threat now. He knows he has met an equal. Examination of your flight data indicates your ship was never struck by hostile fire. I will make it quietly known amongst our operators that your skills are to be studied and emulated. Even under considerable pressure to accomplish a critical task, you never lost sight of the strategic picture. Gathering data from all of Artemis Station's subsystems provides a treasure trove for Cassandra analysts. Personal log, Noemi Laporte, one down. Personal log, addendum, Noemi Laporte, cool. Alright, let's get our statistics. Nothing, because I didn't fire a shot. So our total remains at 14 kills and 4 assists. So, this has been Everything is Permitted. The 16th mission of Blue Planet War in Heaven, the second mission of Act 3 Tenebra, here on Paladin Gaming. This is Paladin Gaming, signing off.